I spoke earlier with Republican strategist Alex Castellanos and Democratic strategist Paul Begala. So, Paul, is Eric Cantor being hypocritical here? I mean, back when a hurricane hit his district, he wasn't calling for offsets for federal disaster money.
Well, of course he's being hypocritical, and more than that, he's being political. He's a very smart guy, so I can't say that he's playing this because he's dumb. He must see some political angle here. I frankly don't. He's got an enormous risk here because not only, of course, did he support aid for his district, which was necessary when Tropical Storm Gaston hit a few years ago, he also has voted, by my count, for $50 billion of rebuilding aid for Iraq and $56 billion of rebuilding aid for Afghanistan with no offsets. And he has voted for $40 billion in over 10 years in aid to oil companies, subsidies for oil companies. So I suppose the people who have been hit by the hurricane, they have two options. Either hope that Cheney and Bush invade them, and then Eric Cantor will send them aid, or incorporate as oil companies, because Eric Cantor seems to support aid to oil companies as well, but just not American citizens hit by a hurricane.
Alex, what about that? I mean, using FEMA to make a point on out-of-control spending or pushing for spending cuts during the debt-ceiling fight, is this now just the agreed-upon tactic of using one issue to fight another battle? Is that going to be the way business is done now in Washington?
Well, I'm not sure that it's just a political point or a politically useful issue. I think the president here is blaming the ATM machine for not giving him any money when he drained the bank account. This is a president who spent $1 trillion on a stimulus that didn't work, another trillion on a health care bill that America doesn't want, and now he's saying, well, let's just keep spending money we don't have. And all Republicans are saying, look, this is important, great. Why don't we take $6 billion we're throwing away on ethanol subsidies right now and use it for something more important?
But
surely,
not all Republicans are saying that.
Surely,
we're seeing Republican governors like Bob McDonnell and Chris Christie saying, you know, attacking the Cantor approach, saying now is not the time to start another big fight over spending cuts in terms of disaster assistance.
But surely in a $1 trillion budget, Anderson, something in Washington has got to be less important than helping the people that we saw with their homes flooded and homes destroyed. And I think that's what you could get support for in Congress. If it's that important, and it is, why did the president spend all the money?
Well, Paul, what about that? I mean, what's wrong with having an offset for federal spending?
Well, for emergency spending, you don't have an offset because, here's the tricky part, it's an emergency, Alex. Look, there's a regular order of these things, and we should have budget debates through the normal budget process. Should we subsidize oil companies the way that Eric Cantor wants to do? Should we be spending billions and billions rebuilding Afghanistan and Iraq with no offsets, but no money rebuilding America? Those are the kind of debates you can have in the regular order. But when there's an emergency, what do? Americans drop everything and go to help people who are in need, and that's what Cantor should be doing.
Paul and I are going to agree on this. You should have some money saved away for a rainy day, and the president should have thought of that, and the Democrats should have thought of that when they spent the trillion on the stimulus that we didn't have, when they spent another trillion on health care that we didn't have. Now that rainy day where we need that is come, and we don't have it. And so,
I
can't spend money out of
thin
air, Paul. You can tell the ATM that it's an emergency, it still won't have the money.
Excuse me for talking while you're interrupting, but I helped the president balance the budget. I know what it takes, and frankly, the Republicans don't.
Actually,
they are the ones who squandered, they squandered the Clinton surplus. And so, and they did it, here's how. Tax cuts for the rich, which we could easily repeal if we need the money, and I think we do. Subsidies for oil companies and other corporations, a war against a country, Iraq, that was no threat to America. We should revisit these Republican parties that exploded it. But when a Republican talks about deficits, to me, it's like an arsonist complaining about the fire department. It is not Barack Obama's fault that we have this god-awful Bush deficit, and it's certainly not the fault of the people who are hit by a hurricane. I mean, come on. Shouldn't something be above politics?
Paul, please, though, it's not fair to say that it's Republicans are saying it's anybody's fault. We're just saying the bank account is drained. Let's find the money somewhere. If Democrats are going into this next election saying there's nowhere in the federal government that we could find a few dollars to help people in need, that there's nothing that's less important than that, and Republicans are going into the next election saying, hey, let's try to act like we're broke because we are, then I think that's the advantage is going to go to the Republicans. So knock yourself out.
Alex, should Eric Cantor, though, if he's proposing these offsets, should it be part of his responsibility to at least list his priorities for what he would cut in order to do these offsets?
You know, I think Republicans have demonstrated a lot of willingness to do that, Anderson, and I think that's a good point. The Republicans
But can we ask Cantor's office? They haven't named any specifics.
But during the debt ceiling debate, for example, Republicans were more than willing to prioritize spending, and I think that would be a great place to get Democrats and Republicans together on the Hill and say, let's prioritize this stuff because we've run out of money.
Paul, Republicans are saying, oh, look, we sent the Democrat-controlled Senate a FEMA funding bill, and they left town for the month.
Fine, whatever. These people are hurting. We
Fine,
need
whatever.
To help them. I'm serious. No, but like, come on, okay, what they left on their vacation. You know, seriously, whatever. When a storm hits, people need help. They need help right away. They don't need help because they're Democrats. They don't need help because they're Republicans. They're American citizens who are suffering damage through no fault of their own. And what's really going on, I suspect, is a really insidious thing where the Republicans are trying to completely discredit government. When they ran FEMA, they discredited it. Now it's being run by competent people. Yes. By the way, the guy who runs it was an appointee of George Bush's brother, Jeb Bush, in Florida, so it's not a partisan thing. But now FEMA's doing a good job, and the Republicans want to defund it. So I think really what they want to show is that the government cannot help you, when in fact it can. When there's an emergency, we need to help
the neighbors. If I could offer a slightly different point of view, I don't think Republicans are trying to discredit government. It's done a pretty good job of doing that by itself. And Republicans are not saying don't help people. They're saying where's the money? And there have to be some priorities. It's time for